Now let's talk a little bit about basic airways. In this case, the patient is unresponsive. We could check for a reflex or a gag reflex by maybe rubbing the eyelid to see if they actually have a blinking reflex. That's one little trick of the trade. If they did seem to have a gag reflex, I would opt for the nasopharyngeal airway. They tolerate it while they're still semi-conscious. The way to measure it is from the edge of the nostril or the nair to the earlobe. In this case, you can see this nasopharyngeal tube would be about the right size. But because I believe that this patient is unresponsive and they probably don't have a gag reflex, I'm going to do a head tilt chin lift, and I'm going to prepare to use what we call an OPA or an oropharyngeal airway. I want to make sure that I have either portable suction or a battery operated or a regular concurrent suction catheter available. Because once we begin to actually put this oropharyngeal airway in, if they do have a gag reflex, that's when they may vomit. Or as I look in there, they may actually have blood, mucus, or something else in the back that I want to suction. It's important to realize that when we do suction, we don't want to suction for any longer than 10 seconds at a time before we oxygenate them again. So in measuring this oropharyngeal airway, we're going to go from the corner of the mouth to the earlobe. As you can see, this red oropharyngeal airway is a little long. I try the next size down, and it's just about spot on perfect. The procedure for putting the OPA in is to invert the tube so that the end of it follows the roof of the mouth till it starts to get closer to the back of the oropharynx. I then twist it. As it goes in, it helps to move the tongue out of the way, bringing it forward and allowing me to put air behind the tongue and into the lungs.